Good evening, students. In the last video of mine, I have showcased to you as to what the problem is. On one side, we have seen that the birth of the words, or the moment the words are there, there are the meanings attached to the words, and we say that the knowledge of the words is gained. And on the other hand, we seen that what is the importance of the presence of recollection in the entire process of the knowledge, and then we say that yes, this is taking place. However, for Vishwanath and the other schools of thought, there is this particular problem, and we need to identify to find out as to which one is that. Therefore, he sets forth in his next paragraph to make us understand as to what exactly is the difference. So here we go with that particular step. Now here you will see that individual person is there. Okay, and let's say that he or she hears the word jar, and that's why I've written out here jar, and the word which denotes the object jar in the word. So the moment he hears, there is that expectation that he looks forward to see the jar, either in the external world or in his own mind. Then he says that the perceptual knowledge has already taken place, or it is taking place also, and with the help of the meaning of the word that is being attached to the word itself, and that word is exact, has got that exact correspondence or mapping with the external object, so he says that the verbal knowledge is taking place. However, let's see whether this is the entire picture. And do you think that yes, this particular picture which is in front of us is valid one, and we cannot raise any kind of a doubt or question? However, for Nayayikas, you know, or the other school, they have said that this picture is not acceptable to all. What does that mean? That means that there are certain schools which do not agree with this particular picture at all. Therefore, he says padajanya padhartha smaranam, that is recollection, and not padajanya padhartha gyanam. So you know, here you can see that I have not included the word recollection anywhere. However, if there is no recollection, he says that how can that knowledge take place? So this is their problem, and therefore they say that we are going to introduce recollection as a step in the entire process, rather than just saying that without recollection also we can get the verbal knowledge. So he says that there is this particular operation which is the instrumental cause for the pada gyanam, basically. So I hope this particular thing is being understandable in a very clear manner, to see the entire analysis, which is very subtle to know. For example, if I simply say padajanya padhartha gyanam, now they say that just because that word has got a meaning, and we see that that word has come up with the word again, birth is taking place, that does not mean that yes, we are going to get the gyanam, that is the knowledge. It has to be that the presence of recollection has to be there in the entire process, and that's what is operation, and this becomes the instrumental cause for the pada gyanam. Now the question arises for us, whether in this also are there any difficulties which is taking place again. Now there, that is what you need to understand, and to make you understand more clearly about it, I will take you through the next picture, wherein you would be able to understand and make yourself much more comfortable with the differences between both of them. Thank you for attending this one, and let me come up with the next one. Till then, thank you. Bye.